Today we will study about physiological buffers. So first of all, what are buffers? Buffers are aqueous systems that tend to resist changes in their pH when a small increment of acid or bases are added in them. That is, we can say that buffers are shock absorber of pH which resist the changes in pH when small amount of acid or bases are added in them. Okay? And then a buffer system is consist of a weak acid, that is proton donor, and its conjugate base, that is proton acceptor. The intracellular and extracellular fluid of multicellular organisms have a characteristic and nearly constant pH which is regulated by buffer systems. Okay, so first of all we will study about bicarbonate buffer system. This bicarbonate buffer system is made up of weak acid, that is carbonic acid, and its corresponding salt with a strong base, that is bicarbonate, that is sodium bicarbonate. So this is made up of sodium bicarbonate and carbonic acid. Okay, and blood plasma is buffered in part by this bicarbonate buffer system, and all of you know that the pH of blood is slightly alkaline, that is 7.4, and that is nearly maintained constant with the help of this bicarbonate buffer system. So the ratio of this two constituent of bicarbonate buffer system in blood plasma is around 20:1, that means sodium bicarbonate 20 bicarbonate 1, that is 20:1. The constituent this 20:1, that means alkali part is more, so they constitute the alkali reserve of blood. And this buffer system involves the reversible reactions between gaseous carbon dioxide in the lungs and bicarbonate in the blood plasma, and actually it maintains the pH of blood through three reversible equilibria. Okay, so this buffer system works in conjunction with lungs. First we will see here what actually happens when an acid enters into blood, or when acid, that means when proton is added to blood. Actually it passes through the tissues, and reaction 1, that is bicarbonate combines with proton, and reaction 1 proceeds, and there is formation of carbonic acid, and due to formation of carbonic acid there is increase in this concentration, and due to increased concentration of carbonic acid there is increase in concentration of dissolved carbon dioxide in blood plasma, because they dissociate into water and dissolved carbon dioxide, and due to this dissolved carbon dioxide concentration increases, and this passes through blood to lung air spaces, and here in the lung air spaces now the concentration of gaseous carbon dioxide increases, and increased concentration of gaseous carbon dioxide exhale through breathe. Okay, and that like this when a small increment of acid is added in the blood plasma, the pH of the blood is maintained. And conversely, the opposite events occur when, suppose we say proton concentration is lower, that means more the carbonic acid will dissociate into proton and bicarbonate, and more dissolved carbon dioxide will combine with water and convert it into carbonic acid, and due to this the concentration of dissolved carbon dioxide will be decreased in blood plasma, so more and more gaseous carbon dioxide will enters from lung air space to blood plasma to maintain the concentration or equilibrium of this reaction. So due to this there will be low concentration of carbon dioxide in lung air space, and it will maintain through inhalation. That means like this you can see here the rate of breathing, that is the rate of inhaling and exhaling carbon dioxide, can quickly adjust these three equilibria to keep the blood pH near constant. Like this it works. Okay, now the second physiological buffer system is phosphate buffer system. It is made up of two components, that is alkaline phosphate, Na2HPO4, and acid phosphate, Na2PO4, in its salt form, and they present in blood plasma in normal ratio, that is 4:1 ratio, and this ratio is kept constant with the help of the kidneys. That means this phosphate buffer system works in conjunction with kidney. Okay, now we will see how it works, the mechanism of their buffering. Okay, so suppose when a strong acid like hydrogen fluoride HCl enters the blood, it is fixed up by alkaline phosphate, okay, and which is converted into acid phosphate. You can see here HCl dissociates in H plus ion and chloride ion, and alkaline phosphate dissociates in sodium ion and their anionic form, and it combines with sodium ion combines with chloride ion forms salt NaCl, and this alkaline phosphate that combined with their anionic form combined with proton conjugate base form combined with proton, and there is formation of acid phosphate. Okay, so and this increased concentration of this NaH2PO4 is excreted in urine with the help of kidney. Then next we will see when an alkali enters, it is buffered by acid phosphate. You can see here, for example, alkali NaOH, sodium hydroxide, it dissociates into hydroxyl ion and sodium ion. And here, you can see here, acid phosphate, that is NaH2PO4, it dissociates into proton and their corresponding conjugate base. Okay, so hydroxyl ion combines with the protons to form water, that is neutral, and then NaHPO4 combines with sodium ion and converted into Na2HPO4. Okay, and the increased concentration of this acid phosphate actually excreted in urine with the help of kidney. Now third type of buffer system, that is that maintains the pH of blood, is protein buffer system, and it operates only in erythrocytes. When medium is acidic, in acidic solution, protein present in erythrocytes or plasma proteins, they act as base and neutralize the acid, and when the solution is alkaline, then protein act as an acid. All of you know that both the groups are present on proteins because they are made up of amino acids, and amino acids has both the groups, amino group as well as carboxylic group. Okay. Now fourth type of buffer system, that is also present in erythrocytes or only, that is hemoglobin buffer system. All of you know that in erythrocytes there is hemoglobin present in the center. Okay. So with the this hemoglobin buffer system work in the pH range of 7 to 7.8, and this structure, the main part which actually helps in buffering action is imidazole ring, which is present in hemoglobin structure. Okay, and the imidazole group of amino acid of histidine, and each molecule of hemoglobin contains 38 molecules of histidine. This is the structure of imidazole ring, which can act as acid, or it can donate a proton and act as acid, or it can accept a proton and act as a base, and helps to maintain the pH of blood.